Hey guys, Manuel Raj here. Just to wish you all a happy new year. This is the second vlog in the series. I'm going to be doing a little bit more this forthcoming year with the release of the Coal Explode second album and also anything that goes on with the Red Elastic Band and also with the launch of my record company, which is coming this year too. I just wanted to thank everyone for their comments and their kind words and their support and their love. And all of the gifts that I've got this year has been incredible. Just a reflection really on the 2017, what an amazing year it had been for numerous different reasons. I mean, obviously culminating with the release of Adios and Your Pussycat and some amazing concerts, and culminating in the Invisible Wind Factory gig, which was astounding. You know, the reviews have been great and the response has been amazing. And what a way to end 2017, it was incredible. So again, thank you all for your continued support, it's been unbelievable. So there's loads of things happening next year, which I'll do another vlog about with regards to the second album and the record company and stuff. But I've got a series of questions that have been asked that I'm going to answer now from various different people across social media and whatnot, conversations I've had. When did you first pick up a guitar? So, first guitar I picked up was my dad's classical acoustic. He showed me one or two things on the guitar, a couple of chords and whatnot. The first time I remember playing the guitar and thinking, wow, this is what I really want to do, was when I went to a friend's house. He also played guitar, and he taught me how to play, what's this one called? The Chain. By Fleetwood Mac, and I remember thinking then, oh, this is pretty good, so I stuck at it. And another kind of influential moment was hearing Working Class Hero for the first time. My dad sit me down and saying, oh, look, son, there's some swear words in this, but just ignore them and listen to the song. And to this day, can't believe how much that moved me. You know, one man and one guitar was an incredibly powerful moment for me, a poignant moment. How did you join the rep? I used to co-produce in Highfield Street Studios with Phil Hartley, and Mick used to pop in from time to time, and he'd be kind of floating around the building and stuff, and used to kind of chat to him then, just hello and bye and talk about the weather and stuff like that, so nothing really serious. But then he played in the Blue Coat Chambers, and I'm one of the sound technicians there, and I did the sound for that concert, and I remember speaking to him before the gig and saying to him, oh, you know, I really love your work and I look forward to working with you. And a couple of weeks later there was a knock on the rehearsal room door, and it was Mick, and he said, I'm just upstairs doing some recording, you want to bring your guitars up? So I did, and contributed to the infamous album that was never released. There was a kind of numerous debates going on about that, but for me I don't think the performances on that album did Mick justice really, which is probably the main reason why I didn't see the light of day. And obviously it was superseded by Artorias Revisited, and the double A side of Koala Bears and Violets. And to be honest, the energy behind those performances and those recordings was just incredible, you know, in comparison to what we'd done earlier. And obviously just blown out of the water by Adios and Your Pussycat, you know, so these things are kind of moving up in stages, which is definitely going in the right direction. What inspires you? Loads of things, you know. Music, obviously. So bands like Radiohead I listen to, Floyd, Nick Cave, and massively into the moment. Rachmaninoff, Chopin, Beethoven, Sigur Rós, Fortet, Nick Drake. So many different things. But I'm also moved as well by nature, and mountains and forests, and oceans and seas and stuff like that. And I think that's where I get a lot of the soundscapes from the Coal Explode, tend to reflect those elements of nature that I love so much. It's the best gig I've been to. Nick Cave, Manchester. I'll do another vlog about that because I've got so much, I think he gave me so much there. And I'm not entirely sure what that is, but I'll do a separate vlog on that, and I'd love to have your comments and opinions on what it is that Nick Cave put me through. What's Mick like to play alongside? Phenomenal, great musician, awesome songwriter, a real innocence to this guy, you know, is a way of which he captures moments in life, puts them into song form. Nobody else does it like Mick. So I'm very honoured to play with Mick and all the guys in the Red Elastic Band. It's a wonderful thing. I'm very lucky. Highlights of 2017, obviously the album release, brilliant. Invisible Wind Factory gig. Hebden Bridge, a concert with Hebden Bridge, I remember that being incredible. And then when's the new album out? I'm about halfway through at the moment. So I've been working, I've done some videos for the promotional releases of the album already. And studio time will commence in March of this year to finish off. So I'm anticipating maybe October, November. So I'm looking forward to that as well. You know, it's an incredibly dark piece of work. So thank you so much for being on board with the Red Elastic Band and with me, and all your comments and your undivided attention and love and all the gifts I was showered with. It was amazing, you know. In fact, this over Christmas, this landed through the post, which is an image of a photograph that John Johnson had taken in Hebden Bridge. It was a bit like a time lapse thing, so it was a bit kind of fuzzy and looked an amazing picture. And this is an impression of that by Serrano Den. And I want to thank him so much for this. I did see this on social media and loved it. And thank you to Carolyn Burns for sending this to me. It's a wonderful gift, and it will end up on the wall somewhere around here in the next week or so. So thank you so much, guys. Any questions, just comment below. And I'll see you all in the next vlog. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.